Hello, NorthGate family, and thank you for tuning in to this week's vlog. Every week seems to be a production here at NorthGate as we continue to press forward towards the return of everyone. It might still be a few weeks, hopefully not months, but we are making steps to be sure that we're prepared to welcome everyone back when we're allowed to do so. It's been a little difficult for me as this conversation about public gatherings develops. You know, we don't want people gathering at an NBA game because there's so many strangers, but we're not an NBA game. We're family. But as family, we have a responsibility and a duty to protect each other even more so than strangers at a baseball game. So we're taking these steps as precaution to encourage those who are still fearful or at high risk. We want to make sure our online services are as fantastic as possible. But if you're going to be here in person when we're allowed, we want to make sure that is a safe environment as well. Masks, health screenings, temperature checks, fewer chairs, those are all precautionary measures to make sure that we are all safe. It's a blessing to be able to continue to serve the Lord and worship Him even during these shelter-in-place orders. Thank the Lord for this amazing technology of the internet and for Zoom and YouTube and video cameras and microphones and all of these amazing things allow us to stay connected. I know that 1912 when the Spanish flu didn't have these things. That must have been an even rougher time. This past week, I've been studying Ephesians with our students every morning during our morning devotionals, and this week we studied Ephesians chapter 2, and I love Ephesians chapter 2, but verses 9, 8, 9, and 10 always jump out to me as so awesome and so amazing, which says, verse 10 in particular says, "For we are His workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared before Him that we should walk in them." I shared this with our district at our district conference, but God has prepared these works for us. He wasn't surprised by the coronavirus. He wasn't surprised by how long quarantine has been, but He has still prepared good works for us that we might walk in them. I want to encourage you to look around to see what you can do for God's sake this week. And as this shelter-in-place order continues, how can you be serving God? How can you discover the good works that God has placed before you, that you might walk in them, that you might participate in the kingdom of God here on earth? How can you encourage your neighbors, your friends, your family? How can you love on them without putting them in danger? It's a tricky situation, but this is a time for awesome, beautiful creativity to serve God and love each other in brand new ways. Sometimes we get stuck in those ruts and we don't get to discover God in new ways, but right now we have to be clever. We get to see God work in new and crazy ways. The church spreads through persecution, and while this isn't persecution, it's a time that we get to be creative in how we love God and love each other and share this beautiful message, this good news of Christ Jesus. So, look around. Discover what God has laid out before you, what good works He's put before you, that you might walk in them. Stay strong, stay focused on Jesus and encouraged, and be loving one another. I love you all, and we'll see you next time.